we've stated the Cholesky factorization theorem, and the way we're going to go about proving it is to first come up with an algorithm that computes the Cholesky factorization, and then we're going to move on and say under what circumstances does that algorithm complete, and that then allows us to put the pieces in place for the proof of the Cholesky factorization theorem. So let's have a look here. Let's say A is Hermitian positive definite, and the claim is that we can then find its Cholesky factor L, which is a lower triangular matrix such that L times L Hermitian transpose is equal to A. Okay. Now, how do we go about our business of finding algorithms? We've seen this already for LU factorization, we've seen it for solving triangular systems, upper triangular systems. And the first step is to take our matrices and to partition them. So we go and we take matrix A and we partition it into alpha 1, 1, A 2, 1, A 2, 2. Now, because A is Hermitian, symmetric, however you want to call it, notice that we only need to store the lower triangular part. And from what is stored in the lower triangular part, we can deduce what's in the upper triangle. And in particular, when we partition it like this, we know that A21 Hermitian has to be here at the top. All right, and the other thing we can deduce is that alpha 11 must be real because it must be equal to its conjugate. And we conclude that A22 is itself Hermitian because, well, if you work it out, it must be. So then we go and we partition L. Now, L is not necessarily unit lower triangular, so we have to expose the element lambda 1, 1, and then L21 and L22 with a zero here. And if we do that, notice that L22 is itself a lower triangular matrix if it's part of this lower triangular matrix. And then if we multiply that times the Hermitian transpose of this, what we get is L21, oops, that should now be a zero. This should be L21 Hermitian transpose. This should be L22 Hermitian transpose. And our claim is that we can choose our L in such a way that lambda 1, 1 is real valued. As a matter of fact, we're going to choose it to be positive. And if we take the Hermitian transpose of a real value, then we just get that value right back. So we don't have to put a conjugate or a Hermitian transpose on that. Right? So now we have partitioned our matrices and we've plugged those partitioned matrices into the equation that we're after, that defines the operation. All right, and what's the next step we typically do? Well, we typically go and we multiply all of this out. So what does this equal? Well, it equals this times that plus this times that. So that gives us a lambda 1, 1 squared right here. And then below it, we get this times that. So that gives us an L2, 1 times lambda 1, 1 plus this times 0. This here we don't even need to bother with because we know that the result is Hermitian and therefore that should be the Hermitian transpose of this right here. And then finally down here we get that L21 times L21 Hermitian transpose plus L22 times L22 Hermitian transpose goes into that position right there. And this must be equal to that. And from that, we can read off what the operations are that must happen in the current step and in the future. Namely, we know that alpha 1, 1 is equal to lambda 1, 1 squared. And we know what alpha 1, 1 is, and therefore we know that lambda 1, 1 must be plus or minus the square root of alpha 1, 1. And we choose to make it equal to a positive number, and therefore we take it to be equal to the square root of alpha 1, 1. Now, wait a minute. In order to be able to do that, alpha 1, 1 should be a non-negative value, real number. And in an exercise, you're going to prove that if A is Hermitian positive definite, then alpha 1, 1 is a positive real number. So all of this is all good. So we can take our lambda 1, 1 to be equal to the square root of alpha 1, 1. Our algorithm now is going to appear right here. So far, so good? All right, now at that point, we know that A21 must be equal to L21 times lambda 11. But we now know what A21 is, we know what lambda 11 is, and therefore we can compute L21 to be equal to A21 divided by lambda 11. We can assign that as follows. And finally, we know that A22 is equal to L21, L21 Hermitian transpose plus L22 times L22 Hermitian transpose. We know what A22 is, we know what L21 is, and therefore we can rewrite all of this as this right here. Bring this to the other side. And from that we conclude that if we update A22 by subtracting off this outer product, then all we're left with is having to compute the Cholesky factorization of this smaller sub-problem. Alright? Now, so what we conclude is that we should update A22 with A22 minus L21, L21 Hermitian transpose. Okay, now, notice that we can actually overwrite alpha 11 with lambda 11. We can overwrite A21 with L21, and we can overwrite A22 with this updated matrix here. That's not one observation. The other observation is that A22 is Hermitian, L21 times L21 Hermitian transpose is Hermitian. If you subtract a Hermitian matrix from a Hermitian matrix, you get a Hermitian matrix. And therefore, we really only need to update the lower triangular part of A22. That's known as a symmetric rank 1 update. And this is where the savings come from when we do our computation. We only need to update the lower triangular part. Now, there's a couple of questions. One is, can we take the square root? And we sort of kind of answered that. The next question is, can we compute the Cholesky factorization of this updated matrix? Okay, and that's where the proof comes in. Namely, we're going to have to prove that this matrix is again Hermitian positive definite so that we can move on to the next step. Over here, what we have now is all of this summarized as an algorithm that overrides matrix A, or rather the lower triangular part of matrix A, with its Cholesky factor.